theater in Hollywood, where audiences have seen the silent screen latest smash, Monumental Pictures, The Royal Wesco. And here they are now, the stars of the picture, Nina Lamont and Don Norwood. Nina and Don, what would you like to say to your adoring fans?
We're pretty dumbfounded at your response to The Royal Wesco. We had fun making it, and I hope you had fun seeing it tonight.
And look, here comes Don's old 40-year-old friend, Cosmo Brown. Don, did you ever imagine this? Here you are standing between the two people who helped you to become the success you are today, your leading lady and your non-tiring partner. Take us back to where they all began.
No, Dora. Tonight is really about the Royal Wesco.
But Don, the story of your success is an inspiration to the young people all over the world. Just one little story or maybe a song from your old ad?
Feet as a fiddle, ready for love. I could jump over the moon or above. Feet as a fiddle and ready for love. Heaven's a worry, heaven's a care. Feel like a feather that's floating on air. Feet as a fiddle and ready for love.
Soon the church bells will be ringing and we'll march with my empire. How the church bells will be ringing with a hey nanny nanny and a ha-cha-cha. Hi, diddle diddle, my baby's okay. Ask me a riddle and what does she say? Free as a fiddle and ready for love.
Like yours is a good thing that's move your silence.
What's wrong with my voice?
Lena, you're a beautiful woman, and the audience thinks you've got a voice to match.
What's wrong with the way I talk? What's the big idea? Am I dumb or something?
No, it's just that Dawn has so much more experience.
Next time, write me a speech. I can memorize it.
Sure, why don't you go right now and reset against this one address?
Care against beliefs. Donnie! How can you let him talk to me like that? Me? Your fiancé?
My fiancé? Lena, you've been reading the fan magazines again? You shouldn't believe all the banana oil columnists dish out. There's nothing between us. There's never anything between us. Just air.
Oh, you don't mean that. Come on, darling, or we will be late for Mr. Party.
Miss Lamont, we are going in separate cars to break up the mobs.
Oh, Tata Donnie, see you there!
Tata Lena, see you there!
Hurry up, Dawn, I've got a lot of press waiting.
This cold up romance, Cosmo, just for publicity.
Prize of fame, Dawn. You've got the glory, you've got to take the heartache that go with it. Now let's get off here.
I think I'd rather walk. I could use the fresh air.
Are you kidding? The fans will mob you.
do me a favor. See this nice hat? Put them on. Step into my limo and you're Don Lockwood.
Sure, why not?
Thanks, guys. See you at the party.
Pardon me, you look familiar. Aren't you Don Lockwood?
Funny you should say that. I'm often mistaken for him. Actually, I'm just your average. Everyday citizens waiting for a trolley here with my girl. Hey! What are you doing? Nothing, just do me a favor. They're after me. I'm going to call the police. Don't worry, I'm not a criminal. I don't care who you are. Just go away. Now look, let me explain. You are a criminal! I've seen that face someplace. You're a famous gangster. I've seen your pictures in the papers or in the post office with a lot of numbers on your chest. Officer, officer.
Yes, ma'am, anything wrong?
This man, he.
Oh, why, it's Don Lockwood.
Don Lockwood?
Out for a stroll?
Actually, yes.
You sure are a lucky lady. Good night, Mr. Lockwood.
Good night, Dan. I'm Mr. Ward. Thanks for saving my life. I'd very much like to know whose hospitality I'm enjoying.
Selden. Kathy Selden.
Enchanted, Miss Selden. Sorry I'd threaten you. I was getting just a little too much love from my adoring fans.
I knew I'd seen you.
Of course. Which of my picture have you seen?
I don't remember. I saw one once. If you've seen one, you've seen them all.
Well, thank you.
Oh, well, no offense, but the pictures on the screen don't impress me. I mean, they don't even speak. They just make a lot of dumb faces. Well, you know.
You mean like what I do?
Well, yes.
Well, what's your loved ambition in life that lets you sneer at my humble perfection?
Well, I'm an actress.
What?
On the stage.
Oh, I'd like to see you act.
Well, I will be. I'm going to New York and...
New York! And we'll all hear you someday, won't we? Kathy Selden as Juliet, as Lady Macbeth, as King Lear. Oh, you have to wear a beard for that one, of course.
Well, laugh if you want to, but at least the stage is a dignified, honorable profession. You're nothing but a shadow on film. You're not flesh and blood.
Aren't you Don Lockwood?
No, Don Lockwood!
Come on, kids, give me a break. Farewell, and for Barrymore. Come on, kids! Give me a break!
Oh, Mr. Brown, you really get me into the movies.
I should think so.
Really?
There are ways.
What do I have to do?
Well, it's simple. Meet me Saturday afternoon in front of Lowe's Theater. I'll take you in, unless there's something I've seen already, in which case you're on your own.
That's my auntie, Tilly.
Thanks, Frances, Brun. Hi, Cosmo.
Dawn, I thought you weren't coming. What happened to you?
Just my fans wanting a piece of Dawn Lockwood.
Yes.
Listen, Cosmo, am I a good actor?
As long as I work for Monumental, you're the greatest of them all.
No kidding, Cosmo. You're my pal, you can tell me.
What's the matter with you? Of course you're good.
Just keep telling me from time to time. I feel a little shaken.
Dawn.
Hello, Ref.
Here you are, Donnie. Where have you been? I was lonely.
Hello, Lena.
Listen, there's a man been coming into my office for months, and he claims he can make talking pictures.
Why? Well, you want a picture to talk?
Well, the Warner Brothers are making a whole talking picture, and they're calling it the Just Singer.
It will never amount to a thing.
This is what they said about the horse's carriage.
Here you go, RF.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're here to honor the brightest stars in Monumental Pictures table. Don Lockwood and Lena Lamont. It's for you two a very special cake full of delicious surprises.
Thank you.
to tell you how much I enjoyed the performance.
Excuse me?
Don't go. Now that I know you live in a cake, let me see you home.
Who is this girl anyway?
An actress on the legitimate stage. She couldn't learn anything from the movies.
Here's one thing I've learned from the movies.
Oh, Lena, I'm sorry!
Whoa, Lena, you never looked lovelier.
Now she was aiming at me.
Let me hear! I'll kill her!
It was just a mistake, Lena, a little accident.
Yeah, a little accident. It happens to me 5 or 6 times a day.
Oh! Where'd she go? Do you see one of those performers rush by?
Yes, sir. I saw her above the door in rather a hurry.
This is Dora Billy with the Hollywood Buzz. Warner Brothers' first talkie dinner, The Jazz Singer, is box office bubble. Meanwhile, Monumental Pictures announces a new Lowell Lemon film, The Dueling Cafolia. Swing to theater soon. I'm Dora Billy, and that's the buzz.
Enter the star.
Contemporary Eddie Patel, better known as The Dueling Cafolia.
Why bother to shoot this picture? Why don't you just release the last one under a new title? If you've seen one, you've seen them all.
Why did you say that?
Say what?
That's what that Kathy Seldon said to me that night.
3 weeks ago, and you're still thinking about it?
I can't get her out of my mind.
How could you? She's the first girl who hasn't fallen in your line since you were 4.
She's on my conscience.
It's not your fault. She lost her job at the Coconut Grove.
I've got to find her.
Well, you've been trying to, haven't you?
All right, guys, put that stuff over there. Get those light wire and set.
Come on now, Don. You can't let a little thing like this get you down. Why, you're Don Lockwood, aren't you? And Don Lockwood, an actor, isn't he? Well, what's the first thing an actor learns? Hey, guys, what's the first thing an actor learns?
The show must go on.
Exactly. Come rain, come shine, come sleet, come snow, the show must go on, right?
Right.
Make him laugh, make him laugh. Don't ya know everyone wants to laugh? My dad said be an actor, my son.
But be a comic, no one day was dead. Stayed in line for those old honkies on Lucky Shine.
Make him laugh. Don't ya know everyone wants to laugh?
My grandpa said go out and tell them a joke.
Don't give me plenty of fun.
Make him roar, make him scream. Take him all the Stonewall sleeves and see.
Nothing funny is going on here.
Hello, everyone. Hello.
Hello, Mr. Dexter.
Hello, Mr. Dexter.
Hello, Mr. Dexter.
Hello. What are we waiting for?
Hey, where's Lena?
Miss Lena Lamont on the set, please.
Miss Lena Lamont on the set, please.
Miss Lena Lamont on the set, please. Here comes Miss Lamont now.
Here comes Miss Lamont now.
I know.
Gee, this head weighs a ton. What top would wear a thing like this?
Everybody used to wear them, Lena.
Then everybody was a dope.
You look beautiful.
Yes, you look great. Let's get onto the set.
Don, I've looked for you the other night at Wally Way's party. Where were you?
Oh, I've been busy
and I know what you're busy at, looking for that girl.
As a matter of fact, yes.
Why?
I've been worried about her.
You should have been worried about me a little. I'm the one who get a whipped cream in a kiss.
But you didn't lose your job and she did.
You're right, she did. I arranged it.
What?
They were not going to fire her. I called him up and told him they'd better.
Why you?
Stop the chit-chat, you love us. Let's shoot the first scene. Quiet on the set.
Quiet on the set.
Quiet on the set.
Roll them.
Rolling.
Rolling.
Rolling. Dawn, cross to her. Cross to her. You love her. Active your eyes. Bigger eyes. You love her. Let's see it.
Hold it, Dexter, hold it.
Cut.
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 Cut. Tell them to go home, we are shutting down for a few weeks.
Shutting down?
What's the matter, RF?
The jazz singer, that's what's the matter. It's sensation. The public scream for more.
More what?
Talking pictures, talking pictures.
Oh, that's just a freak.
We should have such a freak at this studio. Dexter, we've got to put our best foot forward. And we are going to make the dueling cavalier as a talking pictures.
But we don't know anything about talking pictures.
Don, believe me, it will be a sensation. Lamont and Lockwood, they talk.
Well, of course we talk, doesn't everybody?
Lena, your talk may bring back the silence picture.
Warner Brothers, watch out. Monumental Picture will soon be making musical movie in motion picture history.
You heard him. Go home, everyone. We'll let you know when we're ready to start up again. Perfect timing, Kathy. I would like you to meet Mr. Simpson.
How do you do?
I gather you're a very talented young lady.
Thank you.
Kathy, I would like you to sing for Mr. Simpson. Now, if that's all right with you?
Sure, I'd love to.
Hey, Cosmo, can you play a quick audition?
I don't know a quick audition. Can you hum it for me?
Do you know you are my lucky star?
What key?
E flat.
E flat.
I saw you in the night.
Kathy Seldon.
I'm thinking of casting her as the kid sister on this picture.
That's terrific!
Well, before Mr. Lockwood refreshes your memory, you might as well know that I'm the girl who hit Miss Lamont with a cake. Believe me, it was meant for Mr. Lockwood. I'm sorry, Dexter. I should have told you about it. Thanks anyway, Mr. Simpson. Goodbye.
Just a minute, Miss Seldon. RF?
Well, if having Miss Seldon around will make you and Lena unhappy.
Unhappy? I think it's wonderful!
He's been looking for her for weeks.
Are you speaking for Lena, too?
Now look, RF. The owner of the Coconut Grove may do what Lena tells him to, but you are the head of this studio!
Yes, I'm the head of this studio, and she's hired. And don't let Lena know, she's on the lot. Now it's all settled. Take care of it, Dexter.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Simpson.
Glad you turned up, Kathy. We've been looking inside every kick in town.
Thanks, Cosmo.
Taxi!
Have you really been looking for me?
I turned this town upside down. Then I got the New York office on it. I remember you said the New York stage was clamoring for you.
A slight exaggeration. I was clamoring for the New York stage. I started out for New York, then the talkies came.
You know, up to now I haven't thought much about the talkies, but if that's what's brought you here, it's the greatest invention since the wheel. Miss Seldon, will you have lunch with me?
Sure, but don't you usually share a pheasant at lunch with Miss Lamont?
Now look, Kathy, all the stuff about Lamont and me is sheer publicity.
Well, you do achieve a kind of intimacy in all your pictures that would lead one to believe.
All my pictures?
Now I think of it, I think I've seen 8 or 9 of them.
But I still insist, if you've seen one, you've seen them all.
I did say some awful things that night, didn't I?
I deserved them, of course. I must admit I was pretty upset by them. So upset that I haven't been able to think anything but you ever since. Kathy, I seen you again. Now that I've... Kathy, I'm trying to say something to you, but I'm such a... Well, I just can't without the proper settings.
What do you mean?
Wait a second. Music! A beautiful sunset. Colored lights in a garden. A lady standing on her balcony in a rose-rosed bower, flooded with moonlight. You look lovely in the moonlight, Kathy.
Now that you have the proper setting, can you say it?
I'll try. Life was a song. You came along. I've made a way the whole night through. If I but dare to think you care, this is what I say to you. Nature present.
two.
Ta, te, ti, to,
two. No, no, Miss Lamont. Round tones. Round tones. Now, let me hear you read your line.
And I can't stand him.
And I can't stand him.
And I can't stand him.
Can't.
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 Can't. Dude. Now, around the rocks, the rugged rascal ran.
Around the rocks, the rugged.
Rocks. Rocks.
Around the rocks, the rugged rascal ran.
Now, sinful Caesar sip his nectar, sees his knees.
Hiya, Cosmo.
Hold on, boys and girls.
Shall I continue?
Oh yes, go ahead, don't mind him.
Mr. Lockwood, repeat after me. Sinful Caesar sip his nectar, sees his knees and sneezed.
Sinful Caesar sip his...
No, no. Sip his nectar.
Sipped his nectar.
Oh, thank you. Sinful Caesar sip his nectar, seized his knees and sneezed.
Marvelous, marvelous.
Marvelous, do another one.
Everyone, repeat after me. Moses supposes histosis are roses, but Moses supposes erroneously. Moses, he knows histosis aren't roses, as Moses supposes histosis to be.
Moses supposes histosis are roses, but Moses supposes erroneously.
For Moses, he knows histosis aren't roses, as Moses supposes histosis to be.
Moses supposes histosis are roses, but Moses supposes erroneously.
A mose is a mose,
a rose is a rose,
a toast is a toast.
Connect the mic, okay?
Okay, okay, okay.
Okay, quiet.
Quiet.
Quiet. Let's roll them.
Oh, shouldn't have come. You're flirting with danger. You.
What's this wire doing here? It is dangerous.
Cut! Cut!
This is Dora Bailey reporting live from outside a snippy view of the newest Lowell and the Mom picture. Let's see what the cloud has to say.
Who cares that they talk? That picture was awful. What a scream.
Give me pictures like the jazz singer. Did someone get paid to write the dialogue and that voice? Oh, Pierre, you shouldn't have come. I can't stand it.
We are ruined. We are all ruined.
We can't release this picture.
We've got to. We've booked to open in 6 weeks all over the country. But maybe we'll get back. Look, with Lamont are such a big stars.
I never want to see that Lock with Lamont again.
That was just awful.
That was the worst picture ever made.
Don, it wasn't that bad.
No, there's no use kidding myself. Once they release their dueling portfolio, Lockwood and Lamont are through.
Well, things went wrong with the sound. If you just get the technical end straight
out. No, it wasn't that. Everything you said about me is true. No kidding, Cosmo. Do you see anything as idiotic as me on that screen tonight?
Yeah,
how about Lena? I can't stand it.
Don, you're not through.
No, of course not. With your looks and figures, you will drive a nice wagon or shine shoes.
Block hats.
Sell pencils.
Dig ditches.
Or worse still, go back in the footy foul. Feel as a fiddle, ready for love. I could jump over the moon above. Feel as a fiddle and ready for love.
Too bad I didn't do that in a dueling portfolio. This might like it.
Well, why not?
What?
Make a musical.
Sure, a musical picture. Wait a minute, why don't you turn a dueling portfolio into a musical?
That's impossible.
Why? You've got 6 weeks before it released.
Well, sure. Add some songs and dances, trim the bad scenes, add a couple of new ones.
And you got it.
Yeah, but do you think I can do it?
Of course you can do it.
A cinch.
You're right, this picture can't be saved.
Hot dog.
Hallelujah.
Listen. If we can pull this off, this day will go down history for me. March 23rd.
Oh no, your historic day is not the 23rd. It's 24th.
What do you mean, the 24th?
It's 1:30 already. It's morning.
And what a lovely morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
We've talked the whole night.
Good morning.
Good morning to you.
Morning.
It's great to stay up late.
Good morning.
Good morning to you.
When the bass began to play, the stars were shining bright.
Now the movement's on its way. It's late to say goodnight.
So good morning.
Good morning.
Sunbeams with sunshine.
So good morning.
Good morning.
She can't dance. A triple threat.
Wait a minute, I'm about to be absolutely brilliant. Kathy comes here, sing.
Huh?
Sing. Now Dawn, keep your eyes riveted on my face. Watch my mouth.
Good morning, good morning. We've talked the whole night through.
Well, convincing.
Enchanting, why?
Don't you get it? Use Kathy's voice. Lena just moved her mouth and Kathy's voice comes out, singing and talking for her.
That's wonderful. No, no, I couldn't let you do it, Kathy.
Why not?
Because you wouldn't be seen. You've been throwing away your own career.
It has nothing to do with my career. It's only for one picture. The important thing now is to save the Doing Cavalier, to save Lockwood and the Mons.
Yeah.
Well, if it's only for this one picture, do you think it will get by?
Of course it will.
Sure, and it's simple to work the numbers. All you gotta do is dance around Lena and teach her how bow.
Oh, all right, all right. We'll go to Arf and spring on him in the morning.
Well, it's 3 a.m. already. Almost my bedtime. I best be going.
I'll take you home. After you.
Thank you. Better take care of that throat. You're a big singing star now, remember? This California dew is a little more heavier than usual tonight.
What? Really? From where I'm standing, the sun is shining all over the place. Good night.
Good night.
Yeah.
role play back for, would you? Now, just watch her, Kathy.
Rolling.
And would you dare to say, let's do the same as that? I would you?
Stop right there, all right. Kathy, just a test. No focus this time, Sam.
Ready.
Action.
Dare to say, let's do the same as they. I would you?
How's it look?
Great. It's gonna work. It's gonna work.
Kathy, I can't wait till this picture is finished. Then, no more secrecy. I'm gonna let Lena know, let everyone know.
Your fans will be bitterly disappointed.
From now on, there's only one fan I'm worrying about.
There!
Oh! Oh! Oh!
What did I tell you, Lena?
A bomb! Instead of thanks, you will pair.
Now, Lena,
I want that girl off the lot at once. She's not gonna to be my force. Sadly, he told me everything.
Thanks, Zelda. You're a real pal.
Anytime, Don.
Now look, Miss Lamont, Don and I have been-
Don! Don! Don't you call him Don! I was calling him Don before you were born.
I happen to be in love with her.
That's ridiculous. Everyone knows you're in love with me.
Now, Lena, try and understand this. I am going to marry her.
Oh, put a stop to that. I'm growing up and see our now.
Lena, you're a little too late. We're going to get this picture finished. And if this girl weren't in the picture, you will be finished too.
As far as I can see, she's the only one who's finished. Who would ever hear of her?
Everybody! Catherine Neal is a beautiful girl, and she's getting the second lead in her next movie.
She is.
Yeah, and she is getting full screen credit for dubbing your voice.
What? You mean it's gonna say on the screen that I don't sing and talk myself?
Of course, what do you think?
They can't do that!
It's already done!
But no one's know about it yet!
They will. There's a whole publicity campaign being planned.
They can't make a fool out of Lynn in the month! What do they think I am? Dumb or something? Why? I make more money than... Kevin College! Put together!
That's what friends are for.
You will, pal. This business is a jungle. It's dog eat dog. Fair chance waiting to eat your carcass before you end that. And how about that little snake in the grass?
I told ya.
You're right. And I wasn't going to believe you. Can you imagine what lies she must have told him about me? Me, his fiancé, the girl he's gonna marry. You read about it.
Sure, you must be brokenhearted.
Think of all those people when they're finding they're using someone else's voice instead of mine! And what's wrong with my voice anyway?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Yeah, ain't it the truth?
Don't let it upset you, honey. You know how it makes you sweat. And remember last time you got hives.
I'm beautiful, ain't I?
For sure.
And I'm talented, ain't I?
For sure.
If you was a man, you could fall in love with me.
For sure.
And would you ever be unfaithful?
Never.
What's wrong?
More important than sex.
Pardon? Why is he causing such friction? So he could be Mr. LeBond. What's wrong with me? Why all the confusion? I'm quite a girl, a real culture pair. What's wrong?
Working with Kathy Seldon.
So that's the problem. Lena found out. Explain why Hurricane Lena just went for here.
Say, I've never seen the new footage of the new number.
The Seldon girl is great, no matter what Lena says. When the pictures is released, I'm going to give her a big build-up. How much is there left to do?
We're still trying to crack that big production number, boss.
Tap dancing?
Huh?
We've got to have tap dancing.
We can't have tap dancing. The picture takes place during the French Revolution.
How's this? Before a modern section into the picture, the hero is a young Broadway hoofer, right?
Right.
He sings and dances, right?
Right.
One night backstage, he's reading a tale of two cities between numbers. See? A sandbag falls on his head, and voila! He dreams he's back into the French Revolution, right?
Sensational!
Excuse me, Cosmo, but how are you going to do that?
Close your eyes. Close your eyes and imagine this. Don't bring a frown to old Broadway. You've got to clown on Broadway. Your troubles there are out of style. For Broadway always wears a smile. A million hearts beat quicker there. A million lights, they flicker there. Clouds of gray on that great white wing. That's the Broadway melody.
Imagine, could you tell to me again?
This is Dora Bailey talking to you at the premiere of Monumental Pictures, The Dancing Cafelia. Once again, we will unite those immortal screen lovers, Don Lockwood and Nina Namont, in their first or talking, or singing, or dancing musical romance. It is an event that will go down in cinema history.
Listen to them. We're a sensation. It is the biggest thing since Ben Hur.
Lena, you're terrific. Lockwood and Lamont are gonna be greater than ever.
It was good, wasn't it?
Wonderful, Don. It's work. The puppet loves you too.
They're right, right.
And Kathy, we owe a lot to you.
Thank you.
Lena, you're fabulous. You sang as well as Kathy Seldon.
And I'm going to for a long time.
Hey, what do you mean?
I mean, she's gonna keep right on the blank for me.
Listen, Lena, we only did this just to save one picture.
That's what you think.
Listen, you ball constrictor. Don't get any fancy ideas about the future. Tell her, RF.
Never mind, RF. Listen to the applause out there. It's for me, for Lena Lamont. Wait till the money starts rolling in.
She got something here. It's the gold mine. You got no choice.
Part of that choice is mine, Miss Lamont.
You got a 5-year contract, can you?
Just a minute, Lena.
Speech! Speech!
The speech! Don't! They're there for speech!
Speech? Well, yeah! Everybody's always making speeches for me. Well, tonight for the first time, I'm gonna do my own talking. I'm gonna make a speech!
Lena, please, don't do it, don't.
Just a minute, Ross. This is Lena's big night. And she's entitled to do the talking, right?
You're right, right! Ladies and gentlemen, I can't tell you how thrilled we're at your reception for this Dancing Cafelia, our first musical picture together. If we bring a little joy into your wholesome lives, it makes us feel our hard work hasn't been in vain for nothing. Bless you all!
Cosmo-Ref, I've got an idea.
What am I gonna do? Tell them I got a cold, a frog, or something.
Lena, we've got it. Ross, get a microphone and set a bit of that curtain. Kathy, with Debbie Dan, sing for you.
Don, you've got to do it, Kathy.
You mean she'll be back of the curtain, singing, and I'll be out front, making with mouth like in the picture?
That's it. I'll never do it.
She's got to do it.
Of course. She's got to do it. She's got a 5-year contract with me. Get over to the microphone, Miss Seldon.
You heard him, Kathy. Do it.
All right. I'll do it, Don. But I never want to see you again, on or off the screen.
Wow!